Hey, Bolo Buddies, thanks for watching. All right, in this video, I'm going to talk to you about a little experiment I did with my creating a sale and the different percentages, and I'm kind of going to tell you what happened. All right, so I decided to do the unboxing first because it's just way more fun than telling you about the experiment. So the experiment is going to be at the end. All right, Bolo Buddies, I just left the post office and guess what? I got some buddy mail and it is from Pinky's secondhand shop on eBay. She sent me something. Do you guys want to open it up and see what it is? It is a reseller box. I am going to be listing everything and showing you guys how I listed it in this video. So stay tuned for that. Thank you for being here. Be sure to subscribe if you have not already. And thanks for watching. All right, Bolo Buddies, I have buddy mail. This is from Pinky's secondhand store on eBay, and she sent me a gift. Hey, Courtney, just wanted to send you a thank you. Box is for all you do. We all learn so much from you. Thank you. I sent different things, for I know you can sell anything. LOL. Thank you, Tracy. Sorry for the dust. Enjoy. So we're gonna open it up and see what we have inside. We've got some really nice bubble wrap. Let's see what this is. Brentlun braids, the natural looking. Look how cute these are. They're little braids. All right, let's see what else we have in here. Looks like we've got some little plush. We got this cute little teddy bear. It's the American Cancer Society. It looks like it's made by Boyd's. So that's an exclusive. Never seen that one. Super cute. And we have a keychain of unicorns. Oh, look at the cuteness. The cuteness. We have an owl. You know where that's gonna go? That's gonna go on my shelf as soon as my husband puts it up. And there's another one. So cute. Those are keepers. Keeper, keeper. Oh my goodness. Did she hear me mention one time that I also love koalas? That is crazy that she sent me a koala bear. Get out of town. Get out of town. Get out of there. Oh my gosh, it's so cute. Do I keep it or do I sell it? I love it. It is by Fun World Division. Cool. Look how cute he is. He is so stinking cute. Oh my goodness. I love it. This is a solar gas. What is this thing? Is this some sort of vintage advertising? We're going to have to look that. Oh, it's a piggy bank. Oh, it's so cute. Yeah, definitely vintage advertising. Oh my goodness. Slots, 3-pack. PC Mac game. Oh, it's sealed. Wow. Scan the barcode and list it. Easy listing right there. We have breakables. Okay, I will say that I'm not a big fan of shipping breakables, but these seem to be easy to ship. Let me go get my scissors. Okay, so I went in and I took off all the bubble wrap too, because there was a lot of bubble wrap. Check this out. How cool is that? And I don't like shipping breakables, but come on now. This is easy to ship. This is easy. I can handle that type of breakable. And look at this guy. I have no idea anything about these, but I am definitely going to be looking these up. How fun. And I'm sure she's seen in my videos that I always pick up bobbleheads, especially the flocked ones, and these are called nodders. They're little head nods. So that is super cool also. I got a kick out of North Dakota. Made in Japan. You think I can sell it? I think I can sell it. This is adorable. It's a kangaroo. Now, what does it hold? I'm not sure, but it's stinking adorable. It's a little kangaroo. Like what's, it holds something. What do you think it holds? I'm trying to figure out what it holds. Maybe I'll be able to use Google Lens, but that is adorable. It's probably something that should be so easy for me to know. Yes, please. Thank you. Made in Japan. Love it. A little elf. Love finding those, which I don't find them very often. Look at these little glass reindeer. How cute are these? Oh my goodness. They're so cute. and delicate. We'll have to be really careful with those. Let's put those over on the bubble wrap. This says Wedgwood, and it is Wedgwood. Looky there. Wow. Very nice. Very, very nice. We'll look that up. I have no idea what any of this stuff is worth. So as we're going through this video, you're going to see screenshots of how I listed everything. So these items are available in my eBay store. I Dream of Genie inflates to 17 inches. It's a genie bottle by Rubies. So it is a costume prop. And it looks like it is, I don't know if it's retired or not. I can't find a date on it. But cute, super cute. And then we have this one. It says Carlson Dolls, a collector's item made in the USA. Look at her. Look at that beadwork. How cool is that? That's pretty cool, right? Pretty cool. And then we have Puzzle Pets from 1978. Is that a German Shepherd? How cute. How cute. And then what's this? Let's see what this is. Tracy, thank you so much. Oh, this is a Ultimate Warrior Always Believe. It's 2015 WWE. It's a little fold-up poster. So we'll have to look that up as well. Awesome, fun box. Lots of researching to do. Love the little koala. Lots and lots of goodies. And then I've got my little owls, which I'm gonna keep. And then the little plush bear. So lots of goodies, you guys. Lots of goodies. Thanks for watching. Now, this was not a long extended out experiment. It was just kind of over a couple of weeks and just trying to get a feel for things, because something happened that led me to do this. And then after that, I have an unboxing for you. A viewer sent me some buddy mail. And what is buddy mail? That's when somebody sends me a gift. And this was a mystery box. And I'm going to unbox it. And it was jam-packed full of items I love to sell. So it's a really fun box. I'm going to show you everything in it. And I'm going to pop up screenshots of how I listed everything in that box. So we're going to keep this educational also. A couple items have already sold. One of the items sold for $40. So super excited to share that box with you guys at the end of the video. So right now, we're just going to talk a little bit about this. I am not like a charts and graphs type person. I'm just going to kind of share with you my experience. So there was this one day and I forgot to turn on my eBay sale. And I sold something for full price. And I was so excited. And I'm like, maybe my sale price is too much. Maybe I'm scaring people off by having such a deep discount. I typically run sales at 35% off or 38% off. So I started thinking, maybe I should try some different percentiles. Especially right now, things are kind of slow. It'd be a good time to experiment. And the reason things are slow is because I'm not listing as much as I should be. But one thing I will tell you that I have learned recently is when you list, you make sales. So let me give you an example. Yesterday morning, I listed a bunch of items. And by that evening, I shipped in the evening. By that night, before I was going to bed, I had 5 additional sales that were ready to ship. Okay, we're talking sales have been like, but it's my fault. It is my fault. I take full responsibility. I'm doing YouTube videos. I'm doing whatnot. I'm everywhere, everywhere but listing on eBay. So what do I need to be doing? I need to be listing on eBay, because what happens when you list? You have more sales. So with this experiment, there's also the not listing and then listing and all of that that comes into play also. So when I changed my sale, I tried multiple different things. I did 15% off. I think I did a 10% off. I think I did an 18% off. And what I found was I was still making sales every day, no matter what percent off I did. So
there is that. When you have less off, you make more money. And I will also tell you that people were not making me offers. They were just buying it at my sale price, which most of the time people make me offers. So it seems like when I have that deeper discount sale, I get more offers. When I did 15%, 18% off, people were just buying it. I also sold a couple items that were over 10 years old when I was running the 18% off sale, when they were much cheaper at the 35% off sale. So I don't know if it was just like a timing issue, or maybe the 35% off sale on those pants made them seem like they were too cheap and that made somebody scared to buy it. I don't know. So I have no answer for you guys. I was hoping to come back and say, I'm going to start running this sale and I'm going to start doing this differently. And I went back to my 35% off, and then, but I listed that day. So I listed yesterday, put the 35% back on and had the sales. So listing and the higher sale, probably both of them had a little bit to do with having five sales in like, I don't know, 2 or 3 hours, because that has not been happening to me lately. Now, also summer slowdown. I feel like August going into September, we're just going to start to see more increases now. You know, our sales are going to start to pick up. So this is a good time to start listing every day. And I need to set that goal of maybe not every day, but trying to be more productive on eBay, getting more items up. Okay. So that was my experiment. I don't know if that was helpful at all. If you guys play around with your sales, let me know. I do think running a sale is important. Okay. So here's a little tip. And I was talking to somebody about this the other day, and they said they ran their month for an entire month, their sale for an entire month. One thing that I do recommend, and that would be running your sale for 3 days and then switching the percentage for another 3 days, or however you want to do it, 2 days, 5 days, 4 days, 6 days, however you want to do it. But have multiple sales in a week, because when your item is getting ready to, the sale is getting ready to end, I'm pretty sure eBay will send out notifications to people. I do see a spike in sales when my sale is ending. That may only be one or two, but hey, one or two is one or two. So yeah, something to think about. If you're doing long sales, like 6 month sales, think about chopping it up and see if you get an increase on the days that your sale ends. So nothing super conclusive about the sales, other than when you increase your sale, you make less and you make more if you run a sale that is not as high of a percentage. So that's what I learned. So many variables. I feel like I would have to do this for months and months and months to really get a definite answer for you guys. But I made sales every day, regardless of what my sale price was. I made more when my sale was less on the item, but I may not have sold as much. I am going back to the bigger percentage. So that's what my final decision is. What would you guys do? What do you think? Has anyone tried this? If you try it, let me know what your results are. And if you want to see a lot of videos about statistics and different things like that, check out Amber Resells. She has an amazing YouTube channel and she is very analytical, and she will break down numbers for you on all kinds of things, and you will definitely learn. Me, on the other hand, I'm not analytical. I'm not a charts and graphs. I give my stuff to my accountant. I just know if I made money, I'm happy. So thanks for being here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you at the next one.